Well, it's been hard work. Me and Mike have struggled with some of the conditions. Finally paid off.
Linch Hill. See, well, when I get the camcorder out, it's kind of like I leave everyone do the work.
Did you get the camcorder
so
out?
So lazy.
He thinks, just being like the next David Beale, you can just stand and watch everyone else do the work.
So there's a load of people who will go, David Bailey, who the hell's David Bailey? So Linch Hill.
I was thinking more like Steve.
Loading the van up. Late start. Because we slept in. Boys.
Late as usual. Always late. No, I won't be late. Not this time. Late. Again.
Shut up. So yeah, let's have a look. So tackle shop. Mikey's already been in there and had some bait. What is the time? We've had a walk round the lake. Met the other Crusaders already here. Gadge, it's 9:30 in the morning. Friday morning. Loading the van up to take us down to Christchurch. 48 hours. The beast.
You're not straining yourself too much.
No, I'm cool, man. Just making sure you boys are doing this right, because, like, you know. Yeah, but you are Mr. Tetris. That's what you do.
You're unloading it at the other end.
Oh, you'll all want to be crowding around my 10-inch telly later.
Around.
And I do mean telly.
Well, who wants to watch England anyway?
England ain't on.
Yeah,
we're going to watch proper football.
That's the only reason the telly was brought for.
No.
It's pointless.
No, it was brought to watch football. That don't mean you're going to want to watch Super England football. Then, is it? You just be careful with that.
I'm taking up badminton.
We're no good at that either. Right, are we walking the rods down, are we?
Yeah.
I don't know, get them in there.
Let's get the rods in there, won't we?
You would, yeah.
Rather,
I think he's right at the fact that if he drives down, it jumps about. We'll carry the rods, it's cool.
Alright, so
is that a chauffeur?
Cheers, mate.
See you in a minute, mate. Partaking in the food later on. Smile. Good chat. Just date. Stone acres. Big but beautiful. Oh, they're leaving me behind, man. All I've heard is you moan. What's wrong with you boys? I hope he's driving it all the way around the other side. What?
Straight into the camera, is that?
This is HD. You're going to kill people with that.
Listen, I won't say what I'm going to say because it's a family show.
Family show.
Wait till the watershed.
Willow. Excuse the jogging, rod bag on my shoulder. Beautiful down here. It's getting warm now, sun's just come out. It's still a bit overcast. Willows, looks lovely. But Christchurch is the one. Not a lot of fish come out. Not sure they've totally spawned in Christchurch. Willow they've spawned. See how we go. So Mikey and Sean have started making a trip round with a couple of barrows worth of gear. Still a few bits to come back for, and I'm on guard duty, so camera's out. So we had a walk round earlier, when we first got here. Like I say, went and see Crusader 212, who's down here, whose birthday it is. He was meant to be doing a week long stint on here, but unfortunately they were spawning, so he had to go elsewhere. And got down here yesterday, I believe. He's had no joys yet. So like I say, we had a wander, and we decided to be so antisocial that he's down there and we've decided to go on the other side of the lake. He may join us, I think. He may come over, I don't know. But for us, it was the best place to go at the time. It looked good. There's a few fish moving over there. And I've travelled all this way. It's a good point to try and actually try and catch some. So as much as it's a social, it's also about seeing if we can snare a beast. Let's look at the boys doing the work. Sean's got a flat tire on his barra, so I'm sure he's struggling big time. Sun is getting hot, real hot. Right, so 48 hour session, Linch Hill, Christchurch, and it looks lovely, must admit. Not a lot of fish been out, there has been some out. Overcast, but it is warm, it's really warm. The sun was just out and it was beating. Just waiting for the boys to come back for the second trip with the barras. And like I say, this session is more for Crusader 212's down here. It's his birthday, so we thought we'd come and join in with him. And we've got him a cake as well. We always get a cake for whoever's birthday it is. I might see if I can just walk down there on the quick. I don't want to leave the stuff, because the stuff's all over there. Keep an eye on it. But yeah, so it looks like there was people on here the last few days, not many. We're told they might not have quite spawned as yet either, so we'll have to see how that goes. But Mr. 212, Edger, Gadge, down now. I don't know if you can. The back of his bivvy. Got the new Hurricane that Ian Harper sells. I know a good few Crusaders have got one. He's really happy with it, I must say. He's a big old beast. Plenty of room in there for him. Can I get away with leaving the stuff? Quickly, 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 quickly. Anything goes missing, I'm gonna get beaten up. Have a quick chat with Mr. Gadge. Lake looks absolutely superb. Quick. What you doing?
We can see you.
I can't. Yeah, you're doing sneakies. Oh, sneakies! Say hello to everyone.
Hello everyone.
Well, I'm not going to be here long because all that gear's, well, some of the gear's on the floor. But Mark's been here for a while, haven't you?
Yeah.
Was it a day?
Nights now.
Day and a night? Yeah.
Two nights now.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
They've been cruising around on the top. You've been watching them all.
I've seen some out there, but the sun got up proper hot a minute ago. I mean, yeah, it's warm now, isn't it? But then it died off. But
I've seen quite a few cruising within distance of my surface rod, so give them a whirl. Had a bit of a recast since you've gone.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Had a little move out, put it right on them spots out there where them fish were. Good man.
A little extra distance.
All right.
See what happens, man.
I've left them to bust a nut. Sean's got a flat on one of his tyres on his barrel.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, bless him. I've just seen him struggle around with a good couple of barrels full. I'm left on guard and I've left it, so yeah. I'm not going to be too long. But yeah, so this is the Hurricane, isn't it?
Yeah, it's two.
Did you get it off Ian?
Yeah.
I'll
tell you what, it's a brilliant bit of kit.
See?
I love it.
Happy man. There's quite a few Crusaders that have got them. So if you're off thinking of a new bivvy, I mean, that's the two man as well, isn't it? So you've got plenty of space in there, vents at the back. Comes with a wrap as well, doesn't it? Obviously not being used at the minute, but so another happy customer, Mr. Harper. He'll be glad to hear that. Right, cool, let's get back to the gear before it all gets chaffed somewhere. We'll catch you later on, mate. So yeah, Marky's birthday. Not sure how old he is. Number, just a number. But yeah, been here a little while, no joys as yet. Trying a few bits, I know that. Notice there's a bit of weed in the lake. few clear spots to be found, I'm told, so that's what we will be trying to do. What are they doing over there? Can't be having no tea breaks. It's unbelievable. I'll have to crack the whip a bit harder, I mean. I don't know. Get away with too much, some of these boys. Too good with them. Too nice about it. Left me over here guarding, which I ain't done a good job of because I've just wandered off, but. Oh well. Oh, I can hear them, they're coming. Wait for them.
You mean, Marta, I'm busy?
That's hard work, that is.
It is when you've got a flat tyre.
Yeah, that's why I haven't run the banner back.
Huh? All them fish in my swim?
Yeah.
What, in this corner?
Yeah.
What did I say to you? This corner's the one.
Mike's in here. Mike's coming back.
Mike, he's not allowed. Right. Bits in the swim. Shiny.
Hello.
Hello. And Mikey, we've all done a bit of Tarzan work, shall we say. And this is where Mikey's. Now, I'll tell you now, Mike, if it breaks, I'll get it on camera. I'm sending it off.
Target 250 quid, that is. Mikey, your bum looks really big for me.
You've got to get down, yeah? So we've seen a few big lumps cruising along. Found a few clearer spots. You ain't got no glasses on. There's some lumps out there, mate. Plus that big common that's just jumped.
That was massive.
Could be the perch common. And again, do you hear that?
Down.
Further in the corner, isn't it?
Yeah, it's right down.
Fishies. I'm moving down to the corner then.
I threw a sleeping bag up to you, I think.
The elegant way of sliding out of a tree by Mikey. Yeah, that's a good health and safety warning. Mikey is an experienced climber, not, but he does climb a lot of trees, bless him.
That's going to break.
So if you are going to do this,
you can see you've got all,
make sure someone's around.
Required.
Yeah, all the guide ropes and helmets and that. Just, there is two of us here. I can swim-ish. Can you swim?
Yeah.
That's all right. So. You know, we could jump in and say, we probably wouldn't because we'd be laughing. But,
did that actually quite smoothly, didn't
he? He did well, didn't he? Told you, he's experienced at this. You're not even going in this swim.
Just checking.
Yeah.
Just
catch a bit of this stick. PVA, castaway PVA stick. It was made last week, to be fair, so I thought I'd just see how it goes. Looks quite nice. Various ground baits, pellets, bits of broken boilie. Crush them. Right.
duck's destroying my close-in spot. Bivvy's up, bits is finally sorted out. I have chucked the rods out. I wasn't going to bother until tonight, but I decided to cut up the sticks on. One's got a stick on, and one I've just whacked right out. Oh, this duck's going to pick me up in a minute. Right, peeps, finally sorted out. Linch Hill Linch Hill Christchurch. Lots of weed about. Found a couple of spots. Taking a few hours to find a few spots and fill the donk down and try and find some patches in amongst the weed. The lads are still trying to sort themselves out, but everything's in its place. I have just put two rods out for now. I am having three out, one's going in close, but there's a lot of ducks on here. Lots of, a couple of swans. So at the minute, they've given me hassle, so I've not bothered to put that one out. I'm gonna save that for tonight. It is 4 o'clock. That's how long it's taken to sort ourselves out. But I'm quite happy with the marks I've found. I've seen lots of fish on top moving about and that. Some big ones as well, some real lumps. But they are just cruising about at the moment. TV is sorted, made sure the aerial's working. Bought it along, thought I'd give it a proper test out down here. Bought an extra aerial for it, but the aerial that come with it is working fine. My alarms, the ducks swimming through my lines, not good. But at the minute it's just about relaxing. I say two rods, just little sticks on them. One is on a multi rig, infusion baits pop up, the golden balls, and actually the second one's on a golden balls pop up as well, but it's on a KD style, so it's just sitting on the bottom. I'm lying now, actually. No, I'm not. Yeah, just sitting on the boat, KD style. Forgetting where I'm at. I've been so busy, it's so hot as well. It was meant to be overcast and been cooler today, but there's clouds about, but it's really, really warm. So at the minute, I'm just trying to get myself together. And just sorting everything out. I'm going to make some sticks up in a minute. I was going to do a mix for here, but I think the distance that I'm at, to ball it out like I like to do, make little balls and throw it onto the spot, it's just probably not the way to do it. I have got a spawn with me. I guess I could do that, but only the mini spawn, so I think it would take a long time. I may do it later, put some bits out over the top. But I've spread a lot of boilies out there, golden balls and snatch. And I've just sort of, like I say, just whacked two baits out there, both one with a little stick on, the multi-rig just with some foam on, just to make sure it settles down nice. And finally bits are done. Like I say, just having myself a drink. I'm going to have something to eat in me because I am absolutely starving. We left a little bit late this morning after getting up a bit late. Me and Mikey. So yeah, I'm hoping it cools down because it's just too hot and they're all on top, so it could be zigging, I suppose, and maybe that would be an option. But at the minute I'm just happy making sure I've got spots ready. I'm more looking forward to tonight when it cools, and hopefully they'll get down on it. Plane going over. So check the TV. TV's working well. Watch a bit of football later. So you got Stokey. Stokey's just behind me in the swim behind me, and then one past him is Mikey. He's kind of got a corner to himself. He likes to do that. I normally like to do that, but I also like him to be happy when he's fishing.
and be happy with the swim he's in. So, but I also know he's thinking about moving round the corner so he can fish into the sort of reed line that's down by the side of the swim that he's in at the minute. He's waded one out to get it round there, but still not quite giving him the angle that he wants. So yeah. Finally sorted, that's all that matters. I know it's taken a long time today. Finding spots was hard enough because it is quite a bit of weed in here. And just casting and casting until you got a half decent donk and could feel a nice little soft patch or a fairly clear patch, which I think I found on two of the rods. And like I say, the third rod's going to be close in under a big golden patch that you can see down here. It's totally clear, but it's just so close that the ducks are just, and the swans are on it straight away. So yeah, other than that, sit tight, try to stay out of the sun before I burn to death, and start to enjoy really. Mark is still over the other side, he has been round, had a chat, he reeled in earlier, went and had some breakfast and a calf. You can hear the boys talking. But yeah, that's it for now. Right. Still kind of sorting myself out, but 5 o'clock. 5 o'clock, let me show you what's going on. Look at this. Look at this. Just delivered. Spaghetti bolognese. Looking good. Garlic bread to go with it. All good. The telly is getting a proper run out, picking up all channels on the normal aerial, even though I bought another one. So, yeah, feels like I'm on holiday. A few little knocks, nothing special going on, no one's had a fish. We are just all getting our dinner, just having something to eat. Just been making up some stick mixes. Say stick mixes, just the mix. Bit of krill, ground bait, normal ground baits. I bought some bloodworm pellets as well, just because I know they're kind of onto the fishy stuff in here, sticky baits and all that. But obviously I'm sticking with my infusion baits, bits and bobs, but just made stick mixes with some really oily stuff. I've added some tuna to it as well, just to give it that fish flavour. So I've just been doing that. Dinner's just turned up, football's kicked off. Quite a happy Baggins. The other boy's chicken curry, I believe, and chips or something like that, or maybe rice, I don't know. But life is good at the minute, life is good. Eat this, watch a bit of the football, continue sorting a few bits out. The bivvy's a bit of a state where I'm moving stuff about. And yeah. After this, I'll be definitely raring to go and get some more bits sorted, get my third rod out. I brought that in because the ducks were killing it. I'm going to wait till tonight. I'm probably going to wade out as well and just drop it in the margin and a nice clear patch there. And yeah, just enjoying it now. Still warm, cooled down a little bit. Breeze has got right up. I know you can hear the TV, so I'm talking very loud over the top of it. I think Sean will be down in a minute, but yeah, it was just a quick update. See how spoiled we are when you're at Linch Hill Fisheries. Delivered to your swim, food, and it smells and looks gorgeous. And I'm not letting it go cold, so I'll catch up with you soon. So it's 20 past nine. Not a lot going on, but I thought I'd just try and show you this sunset. I have taken some photos.
and like I say, we've been busy sorting ourselves out. Been more of a sorting out day to day. I've just put my three rods out, two of them on the spots, and one of them is just round the corner. I waded out with. So the left and right rod, roughly the same distance. One, obviously the middle rod, should I say, straight out in front. Probably about, I don't know, 40, 50 yards, not very far, where I found a nice donk down and a bit of a smooth patch in amongst the weed. Left hand rod's the same. And the right one is just round under this tree. I waded out, found a nice clear patch, and literally spread a load of boilies while I was out there and dropped my rig straight on the spot, and it's sitting absolutely perfect. So I'm happy at the minute with the rods, and just seeing how it goes. But yeah, it's been a hot, busy day, to be fair, trying to figure out the place and the weed and that it's about. So it's all been about that today, really. Trying to sort each other, sort our setups up, sort setups out. You might be out where the football France game is on. And what a stunning sunset. So, nice and relaxed day today. Although it's hard work, I mean, we haven't really been on it, just getting the bits ready and not stressing out too much. And we're going to enjoy the night. We've all had a nice dinner, delivered of course by the lovely people that work at Linch. Spaghetti bolognese, garlic bread was absolutely divine. The other boys had chicken curry and chips, I believe, which they're more than happy with. So we'll look forward to having something tomorrow, something different. And like I say, it's just a relaxing time at the minute now. We're all just relaxed. Cups of tea, chit-chat, everyone's got their rods out and happy. And just enjoying being out. No phone signal down here. Not for me anyway. I know some of the boys are getting a little bit of signal, but not getting no internet, nothing. So I'm afraid I've not been online or checked up on the group. So I hope everyone's behaving themselves. But yeah. Well, when it's like this, you can't sit indoors. Still no fish, although we've seen lots of fish moving about today, been up a lot of trees. Mikey's been climbing around, I've been climbing around. Everyone's been out in waders looking for little spots we've seen. So like I say, plenty of work, plenty of groundwork. I've done no mix today. I did plan to do a mix, but I don't know, I just don't fancy it. I've stuck with scattering boilies, obviously the infusion baits, snatch, and the golden balls. And I'm just fishing in and around that, like, or they're spread over the top of where my rigs are. And yeah, fingers crossed we're going to have some action during the night, well, or in the evening. Early would be nice. But yeah, I'm going to enjoy this, sit back, another cup of tea, and just take it all in.
having fun.
Yeah.
Looks like a cattle on. Okay, and all this.
Yeah, I'll just put on twilight mode. I've been practicing on that. It looks nice, the old sunset and that.
Do you want a drink? Coffee or tea? Yeah, I'll put
another
kettle on.
Sure. I'll put a kettle on, I ain't bothered. Kettle. Come and watch the football, you bunch of donuts.
I'm still in mourning.
France are about 10-0 up.
I'm still in mourning.
In mourning? What, you expected to get out of the group?
No, I just didn't expect to get humiliated.
Where's the muffins?
Oh, there's muffins.
The muffin man?
Where's the muffins?
Do you know what he's on about?
No.
We got blueberry and chocolate muffins. Yeah. You got biscuits?
Biscuits, mate.
They're the best ones.
Oh, you can come more often.
Huh?
You can come more often.
You only bring me for the oat cakes.
Well, yes. Yeah, it is true.
I've established the only useful being of my is oat cake.
It definitely is. You are the oat cake king.
Yeah.
You shouldn't lower yourself like that. I mean, we love you.
No, you don't.
We do.
You love the oatcakes more.
But we do love the oatcakes. But we do love you. But more the fact you do a lot of the cooking as well.
Yeah.
So
it's been nice this time, not have to worry about that.
Yeah, you've enjoyed that, haven't you? Well, sat back with your cider earlier. Mmm. Mm.
I'm already planning tomorrow night.
You're not having curry tomorrow?
Huh?
Not having curry tomorrow?
No.
Something different?
Yeah.
That bolognese was nice.
I'm thinking pie, chips, peas, gravy and some bread and butter.
I'll keep him going for glory.
You've got to make the most of it, haven't you?
But I don't know, that bacon cheeseburger thing that with chips sounds like...
Yeah, but I'm going to be eating bacon for breakfast.
Yeah.
Ah, you got a good shout there, yeah.
I'm thinking spag bun with chips.
You have to get extra chips.
Yeah, that's what I dropped a clang with tonight.
Pack of pie and chips.
A Coke as well. I forgot.
I will reminiscing about food.
Been a highlight of the day so far, really, hasn't it?
Only because you've actually been able to enjoy it without, like you say, having to put it all together and sit there over a stove slaving away.
And now Mike's doing brew up.
Michael?
I apologise to you.
After the watershed, to
be fair. I must apologise for... Hold on, it is after nine. Yeah, I can go out of it now.
Look, the group, right, doesn't have a watershed.
It's after nine.
I don't care. You're old enough to know better. And yeah, ugly enough, old enough.
Alright, this is the ugly.
So it's Saturday morning, 8:30 in the morning. Everyone's up, cups of tea, etc. No joys, not a single beat off any of us. But today we start really getting on it. But first is breakfast. Oat cakes are being done. Shawnee and Mikey are working on it now. Have a look. Breakfast. The chef.
Morning.
The sun is up, the wind has turned slightly. It's not too warm here yet because we're in the shade, but it is going to be warm, I can feel it. Yeah, quiet night. No movement for anyone.
Sous chef.
A few people here. One, two, three, four. Must be at least seven with us on here, I'd imagine. Might be one or two more. Didn't hear nothing in the night. Didn't hear anything in the night, did you, for anyone else?
No, quite. I spoke to a few people, and another bloke turned up in the corner.
Mm.
But no, no one had known. Mark was sad that when I went round there.
So, breakfast time. I'd say, what is it, half eight, isn't it, I think? Half eight. Yes, sir. And have something to eat, and then may think about moving the rods. I'm not moving my margin rod. It's been quiet. I waded out, done it last night, and nothing's touched it. But I know it's bang perfect, so I'm going to leave it where it is until possibly later on tonight. But the other two, I may have a move about with. But we'll see. Cooking up a storm.
Going off. That. Sausage. Bacon.
Hold on, this is... Is that ready then? Is it to go?
This is a great advert for the NHS. Eat healthy, folks. It's not worth it.
It's not worth it. It is worth it. It's
definitely
nice.
Worth it.
Meat, 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 meat.
Got any salad? We're putting on the bank if we can.
What'd you say?
Got any salad?
Are you swearing on camera? We don't allow swearing. Salad.
Alright, Marky. Hit me, mate.
Not literally. Punch him on the nose.
Oh, sausage. Okay, sausage.
Oh, Marky's first. First oat cake. Are you excited, Mark?
A little bit. It's the only reason I come here.
Hey. Some people call them the devil's food.
Devil's food.
We call them good. It's the only reason we are Sean.
Of course.
Isn't it?
You can't get them online, you know, no mail order. You don't have to put up with me for 2 days.
Is it?
Yeah.
Mike, are you listening to this?
Why no one told us that before?
Edit. Everything you do, edit. Hold on, Mike's going on camera. Edit. Jesus. He's like having a little kid around, isn't he?
Just have to put that bit on after 9 o'clock.
Parental warnings at the beginning of it all.
Parental warnings, Mikey's on the camera.
You get a horn and then one of the things that flashes.
I actually probably can now. I've got new editing software that I'm still getting the grips with.
But... red, brown.
I think I'll just have this.
No, what?
I'll go for a bit of red then.
It's chilli red.
I don't have it as it is.
It's not hot chilli, it's just sweet chilli. Marky.
Just get in there, innit?
First oat cake. First oat cake.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Enjoying.
Are you available next weekend, John?
Yeah.
he takes party bookings.
Yeah. Where it starts, right, if you pay for my fishing, I will cook your own cakes.
That is worth
every penny. Any Crusader, lumber or not.
Discount list. Oat cake maker. Mikey, you want to swear or anything? Just
edit.
Flipping hell.
Sold?
Oh yes.
Definitely need to get this going, some nationwide expansion.
I'm telling you, boat sales down our way, mate. You could sell them by the millions.
The ideal for this
fishing.
Or even for fishing, so, like, yeah.
Get a lake.
Can you imagine you had a little cabin on here, it was just doing oak cake.
Trailer on the back.
Mikey,
yeah,
that's
all right.
The trailer. That's his thing.
Yeah, I don't even need a plate, look. I'm just
going to
shovel.
Who's next?
Good, right?
You having one next?
Yeah, whatever, mate. Yeah, I can wait or whatever. You're already like the original OC. Ain't an OG. OC. Oh,
Mikey,
cake.
That was some bacon sausage, mate.
This is your job.
I'm just cooking it. I'm just cooking it. I'm just sous chef.
Could have done one sausage to get more out of them. One half a sausage.
You want half a sausage? It's coming back. This is how it was earlier.
This is how it's going. Look how clear it is.
They're fucking monsters like they are, aren't they?
They're long, aren't they?
There's four in there now, isn't there? Five. There's five in there. One, two, three, four, five.
They are long. That looks like I've got a bit of gut on you now, aren't
I? I've got a rod on this bush.
I don't know if you can walk out far enough to do it, can you?
Yeah, I will do. Watch me. I'll swim out. It's quiet. I'm getting a rod on the edge of this bush and tell him where I've been on.
Look at the big, two of the big boats just coming down something.
That one there, he's back to us, he's got fucking girth. He's got some whip on him now. Too close, don't want to spawn them swooping out of there. Yeah. Leave them in there. But I'm gonna get rid of the spawn.
Mikey, overlooking the water. We've been up a few trees this weekend and we have seen some royal hippos. 30s, even a couple of 40s we think we've seen there are so big. But it's good to get up the trees and see what's going on. Just be careful if you do it, people. Like I say, it's good to have someone around just in case anything happens. You have to be very careful. Mikey loves to find the highest tree, as you can see, and makes it his mission to climb them. But you can see lots going on from them heights. had the car pull up for dinner. Trying the other battery and it's full charge.
Full charge?
Yeah, boy.
Was that the full charge just then?
Nah, this is the new one I charged before we come. The big battery, it looks like that.
Bad boy.
Alright.
What are you doing?
I'm just having a chill out.
Just relaxing. Right, what's the time? 20 at 5?
5.
Quarter 5. Nothing going on apart from Baggins getting burnt head. I still can't tell. Swollen. Yeah, so hot, and the fish down here, we're pretty sure definitely haven't spawned. We've seen some massive fish, 20, 25 strong, 30s, 40s, huge, but they are not interested in food. They are grouped up together, tight, and looks like they are getting ready to spawn, definitely. No actual signs of it, but I think it is coming. So unfortunately, all we've done is camped for 2 days. It's all good though. But we're gonna have a look in the spot again. See if we can see any fishies. So 5 o'clock. So not a lot of recording because not a lot's gone on, to be fair. Swim 15, you might notice that my rods have moved. I've now got my left rod just going around the corner of these reeds where there's a little patch I've noticed from the climbing of trees. Put a little bait around there. And the angle's a bit better. Still extremely warm. Just very quiet. Only the one fish we know have come out, which was 34. It's just not happening. Tried zigs, tried all different various coloured pop-ups, on choddies, on all kinds of different methods. Cutting the margins, couple at distance. It's just not worked out. Like I say, I think they're possibly thinking about spawning. They're huddled up together, a lot of them. No crashing or anything yet, or anything, you know, bashing about in the reeds or anything, but they are going around in packs. So whether they're starting to think about it, it certainly seems that they've not got their mind on food. But persevere on. Who knows, we may get lucky. Not worried about the size, just to catch one between us would be good. But it's not like it's just us, it seems like everyone's struggling. It's 8:05, Saturday. And it's been hard work, really hard work. No fish to talk of. Burnt to bits by the looks of my head. Oh, I'm going to suffer with that. That's why I don't like the sun. One rod out, sorted for tonight, which is out in the middle. Lots of seagulls about and that, so I've not been out to put no bait around it yet. A couple of rigs ready to go for the left and right rod, which I'm having in close on spots that I've seen are clear. Waders on and walk them out and put them on now. But the left one's more of a little flick and I'm hoping to hit the spot. And the right one, I can literally hand place it on a spot, so it's the only places I really feel comfortable with at the minute. Tried all sorts today. We've tried zigging, we've tried different kinds of choddies with various coloured baits and pop-ups. And yeah, it's been really hard work. Again, as we say, I think they're looking to spawn again, maybe. They're all grouped up, been up the trees, lots of big fish all together. So not the most joyous weekend. Nice to be with boys and that, but we like to have a few fish, especially the ones we've seen floating around, because I'll tell you what, they are massive. So really tried it again. Mikey's resorting his rigs, having another pop at trying to figure something out. I am, like I say, just done all my bits, and middle rod has gone out because it was a simple straight down the middle chuck. The other two I'm waiting to wade out and wait for Mikey to come down because he's using the waders at the minute. And also I need him to climb the tree so he can look down on the spot for when I wade out my left one, just to make sure I'm on it, because it's only a tiny spot, the size of a bucket lid basically. Shawnee is having a little nap. It's all been too much. It's been blazing hot, really blazing hot. We've all had some food. Unfortunately, my phone has been out of reception all the time I've been here. I've reset it. I managed to get a bit of reception and try to get on the group. And I know there's been some bits going on, which hopefully admin have sorted out. But also now the power pal ran out yesterday. It's just got no power in it. So I haven't been able to watch the telly, haven't been able to charge no phones. So I'm a little bit disappointed with that, to be honest, because it hasn't been on that long and it was left charging for 2 days. So I am definitely in need of uprating my power source. So Mr. Tackle Tart, Roy Lawler, I'll be coming to, I'll be speaking to you at some point. I want one of your little boxes you're doing, mate. I'm definitely in need of one of them. But a little bit of a tidy up in here. Like I say, we've had dinner, cleared up a little bit. I bought lots of bait this weekend, expecting to, you know, do a mix and stuff like that, but it's just so weedy. And the spots I am finding are fairly clear. Are at a bit of a range where I can get boilies out to them, but I'm not going to make a mix and try and boil it up, because it ain't happening. Plus the fish are just not feeding really. So other than scattering a few boilies around the general area of where I put baits, there's no other food really going out. Obviously sticks as well I've been doing, adding a bit of tuna to them just to slick it up a bit, but nothing seems to be making the extra difference at the minute. It just, everyone is struggling. Everyone on the lake is struggling. Not heard anyone catching anything. A few other people have turned out. I've got two more down the way now as well. So yeah, we'll enjoy it tonight. I mean, it's nice when the weather does cool down and we can sit out and have the radio on and that. We'll listen to the football and stuff. But yeah, so not a lot been going on. So I haven't done a lot of camera work, to be fair. Not a lot of pictures. Not a lot of anything, apart from trying to get my head round, you know, trying to crack something on here, and don't want to move stuff too much. Once I've got a spot, I'm trying to just leave it, you know, and hope that the fish move in on it, if I'm happy with it landing in somewhere that hasn't got a lot of weed around it. But we're going to carry on, obviously. Who knows, like, we've all made plans for tonight. We're going at it again, trying to revamp ourselves and get the energy going again. Like I say, two spots, I've done all sort of new rigs. Stiff dinge on one. I've gone for a straightforward bottom bait, the infusion snatch, on the right one, because I know I can hand place that on a clear spot, so little stick. And I'm actually, while I'm out there, I'm going to drop a few bits in there so the ducks don't know about it, because there's a lot of geese, ducks, swans. As soon as you throw any bait out, they are wiping it out completely. So I'm going to wait for that to get a bit darker and literally put my hand in the water and drop that, so they don't hear no splashes of bait going in, anything like that. So yeah, we're all going to sort of just go for it tonight again and just try and look at it freshly and maybe new rigs. I think Mikey's done new rigs. Sean, like I say, he's having a little bit of a sleep at a minute, but he's done new rigs as well. He's seen a couple of spots, tried baiting them earlier, but again the swans just wiped it all out. So we're all waiting for it to sort of die down, get a little bit darker, watch the older ducks go asleep and sort of get ready for bed. And then that's when we're going to try and get our plans into operation. So yes, little update, it is late again, not been a lot of recording, so sorry about that. But obviously if there'd been more action, more fish, then yeah, there would have been more, but I'm afraid no joys. You don't want to see me eating my, I had another bolognese tonight, which again, wicked. The boys had pie, chips, beans, gravy, all that. They were more than happy. So yeah, if you do come down here, you're well looked after as far as food. People coming around taking the orders at your swims. The calf's down there. You're really well looked after. If you're thinking of travelling here a few hours or whatever, sort it out of them, let them know you're coming, or turn up if you want. But trust me, you don't go far wrong. You're very well looked after. Great people, all of them. Nick, the bailiff, who walks around, drops the food off. Julie, who's in the calf working in there, lovely lady, again, does everything you need. And they do everything they can to just make sure you enjoy yourself while you're here. And we are enjoying ourselves, just a little bit of a headache. And oh, I'm going to be so sore. I should have put my cap on earlier, but oh well. I'll have to suffer that, won't I? But fingers crossed, as I've been saying when I have done any recording, that maybe something might happen this evening, tonight. We've got till tomorrow afternoon, and then it's the worst part of it all, packing down. We've got to barry it round to the other side of the lake, where we've paid to Nick will come and pick us up in the van and put all our gear in there and take us down to the car park. It's a little bit of a walk from the car park, but for little money, all three of us can chuck all our stuff in the van and it all gets taken down to the car park. So again, looked after to the maximum. But it's just the slight walk around the lake to get it there to the van, you know. It's never nice packing up either way. But yeah, so hopefully an update later with some good news of some sort. And if not, it could be that you just get an update in the morning. Ta-da. Right, 20 to 10. No joys through the night. No joys this morning. One little run, Sean had earlier, but nothing on the end. And yeah, it's packing down time. The boys already packed down. I am doing mine now. And we'll be off by 12 o'clock the latest, midday. So unfortunately, another session together where it's not worked out. But lovely fishery. Weather, if you like this sort of weather, it's been blinding, but oh, I can't stand it. And yeah. Been a great session, always a good session being with the lads. Just could do with some fish. Just the wrong time to come. They're definitely looking at spawning again, or if they have spawned. But I don't think they have spawned, I'm not sure. Can't be full on, but from what we've seen, they look like they're thinking of spawning again, so food is definitely not on their mind. Nobody from around the lake has had a fish. Been dead quiet for everyone, so wrong time by the looks of it, but that's the way it is. So packing down time, walk back to the car, get the car loaded up after the van picks us up, or picks the bits up and takes it down, and then we'll be making the head home. So this could be the last bit of video from me for our trip down here at Linch, Christchurch Lake. Who knows? Rods are still out, so take me an hour to pack away, and you never know what can happen in that hour. Yeah. The invasion.
I not heard a sheep.
Did you see that thing on Facebook the other day? Like 2 million ducks all migrating in Thailand from one lake to another. There was, like, the whole road was just streaming with ducks, like, it was going mad. Yeah. Oh, quick, he's putting us on. You've been frying. Run!
Don't do anything stupid. Come this way, let me take that.